Hi friends, today we will discuss the answer for question number 27. So 27th question is from Ethics GS paper 4. The question is about social responsibility of the scientists. So first, the first part of the question is, scientific community has ethical obligation towards society. Do you agree? You have to tell, if you agree, you have to tell, I agree because of following reasons. That means your opinion should have evidence, should have reasons. Then in this context, explain the scientific social responsibility. This question is given because in January 2020, this year only, this year, after the 107th Indian National Science Congress, the Department of Science and Technology said that government is going to release scientific social responsibility policy. Hence, keeping this in the view, the question has been framed. So, when you know the background of the question, if at all you know the reason why question is framed, try to write that reason either in the introduction or in the conclusion so that the evaluator understand that you know the reason behind the question. However, if you do not know the reason, then you normally write the answer for this question. Now, so for this question, before directly starting as yes, I agree, of course you can, as it is 10 marks question, you can directly say yes, I agree that scientific community has ethical obligation due to following reasons. You can start directly. However, I would suggest you to write introduction of two lines about something, some create introduction. For example, I would say you can use the emotion in the introduction or any current happenings. You can say that in the recent years, we are seeing several scientists working on creating new viruses or working on creating new weapons, either bioweapons, chemical weapons or nuclear weapons. In want of recognition or in want of wealth or power, etc. But they are not remembering their social responsibility as scientists. So like that, you can start the answer. So in this kind of introduction, you are showing your strong emotion towards certain scientists who forgot their responsibility. At the same time, you're talking about the current happenings, about creation of new viruses, whatever it may be, or creation of new weapons, etc. And then you can start the question. So that you can stay relevant in the examination, your answer will be relevant if you start like that. Then, now coming to the actual question, the question is, do you agree? You say that, yes, I agree. The scientific community has obligation, ethical obligation towards society. So, because of following reasons, you can say because of following reasons. One reason you can say is that as most of the scientific research at government level is happening from the taxpayers' money, so it is a responsibility to think about the taxpayers, it is common public, that their innovation should be useful to them, not harmful to them. Also, you can say that these scientists who have become scientists have learned the basic sciences of society only, from the school only. So it is responsibility to produce an innovation which is useful to society. Similarly, you can say science without value is dangerous, is harmful for society at large. For example, you can give examples. Not only this example, you can give another example. You can give example of dynamite by Nobel, Alfred Nobel. Or you can say the scientists involved in the Manhattan Project have got that moral question of their involvement in creation of nuclear weapons. So you can talk about that one. Or you can give any other example. For example, you can give an example of Wuhan, a laboratory in Wuhan, where scientists were working on certain viruses, their ethical dilemma or the moral questions. You don't need to explain it in detail. Just write that word and leave it. Evaluate, understand what do you mean by it. Also, they have a responsibility to publish the result. Any scientific innovation, the result has to be published. It should be transparent. Only then we can trust the research. Similarly, it is a responsibility of the scientist or the laboratory to spread the knowledge. Whatever knowledge they have gained through research, they have to spread through seminars or newspapers or, you know, printing textbooks, etc. The knowledge has to be spread. Similarly, it is a responsibility of the people working in these laboratories to blow the whistle if they find something illegal happening, not only in the R&D laboratories, but also at the academic level, in the academia institutions or even in the industries, if any scientific research is happening against ethics or against law, if it's illegal, those who know about it should blow a whistle, should make everybody know about that. So you can end this by saying that there should be a code of ethics. You can say that, and then you can say there should be an international code of ethics, or at least national code of ethics that everyone should follow. Now, coming to the second part of the question, they're asking you what is scientific social responsibility. You can say, you can define scientific social responsibility as confluence of scientific knowledge with social concerns. Social concerns. A confluence of scientific knowledge with the social concerns at large. You can say it's a linkage. The scientific social responsibility is a linkage between the science and society. And also, as I told you, it is a responsibility of scientists to make their research easily accessible through journals or through publishing to everyone, to make it transparent. Also, it is a responsibility to ensure that innovation is useful to society, or at least not harmful for the public or society. So this is what we mean by scientific social responsibility. Now, as I told you, in the conclusion I am writing why this question is given. I would say that in the recently concluded 107th Indian Science Congress, the Department of Science Technology has mentioned that Government of India is going to release a scientific social responsibility policy. So hence you can say that the Government of India recognized the importance of ethical obligation, moral obligation of scientists towards society. So in that way you can end the answer. So friends, the question for tomorrow, General Studies Paper 1, this time I am giving from Geography. It's a very important question. Comparison, you have to compare and also try differences between the temperate cyclones and tropical cyclones. See you friends, bye.